Well, Barry, we're going to try and step forward a little bit. Much to our detriment, last year's Cheltenham preview, you cleaned us out with an each-way double. Of course, you rode both of them, which was fantastic for yourself, on jet ski and more than that. But looking ahead to this year's Cheltenham Festival, let's start off with Bobsworth. He's a horse that's very close to your heart, having bought him and sold him. It was a strange Gold Cup last year, but surely he must come into the reckoning again this year.
Yeah, I suppose the Gold Cup, it didn't really live to expectations. Bobsworth came there to win and or the challenge between the last two, but he just didn't see it out. He just didn't sparkle on the day. Silvernackle County ran a good race, but you know, a few surprises to see the first two come through at long at big prices. But you'd like to think that, you know, if Bobsworth can get back there next Cheltenham in the form he was there 2 years ago, you know, he'd be a tough nut to crack.
And Barry, will the plan be to come back to Leopardstown, where he was so successful last year in the Lexus Chase?
That's the plan at the minute. It's just difficult for him to find decent ground in these day and chases. He gets a very hard race if you run him at soft ground. So Leopardstown at Christmas is an ideal start for him. But the Pillar Chase at the end of January in Cheltenham could be very heavy. So that wouldn't be a great race for him between then and the Gold Cup. So he might struggle to find a race between Leopardstown and the Festival. So we'll just have to wait and see. And he won it. The year he won it, he went there straight, I think, from the Hennessy. So it's no big issue for if he doesn't have a run in between. So once he can get there in good shape.
And Barry, we're going to talk about one of the superstars of the 2 mile game, Sprinter Sacre. He was exceptional winning Cheltenham Ancient and coming to Punchestown and winning the Boylesports Champion Chase. How is he, Barry? And can he, I know it's hard to ask this or maybe hard to answer it, but can he get back to those heights where he once was?
Sure, we still hope so. He worked last Friday and Nicky seemed to have, you know, saw a little bit of a little sparkle. So he worked, he's supposed to have done a nice piece of work on Friday, which is the first sparkle he's shown since, really. So we're hoping, health-wise, he's in great shape. There's no issue with the heart, everything seems to have settled down. So hopefully he's on his way back.
And Barry, another horse we're just going to mention, it's terrible to mention horses who haven't run in a while, but Simonsig, ultra talented, could go over 2 miles, could go probably over 3.25 miles, he just has that much about him. What's the situation with him at the moment?
Yeah, he's in training, he's on the go. I jumped 9 or 10 fences on him there a few weeks back. The King George is still a possibility for him. He's had a few little tiny health niggles, not an awful lot, so just little hold-ups have delayed him. But he's in good shape, so whenever them little niggles disappear, you'll see Simon Sig somewhere like where he was.
Barry, before I let you go, one for everyone out there, just to have a little flutter for the Cheltenham Festival. Who would you go? I know it's very early, we're only in December, but is there a bet that you see that might tempt a few of our customers?
Well, I think Bobsworth, if he gets there in the shape he was in, he sets the highest standard in the race of what we've seen. So I think he's going to take beating if he's in good form. And I'm mad about Joss's Hill. I'm very sweet on him and he jumps well. I know Unda Sue is going to be a big challenge, but I just like Joss's Hill a lot.
There you have it, folks. Thanks very much, Barry, for joining us here outside our Grafton Street shop.